Hello there, welcome back to another draft video here on channelfireball.com. I'm Marshall. So we've got Amonkhet, and we've got a decent pack here. There's some cards I really like. Cartouche, I like Synchronized Strike a lot. I like Bone Picker a ton. I'm not a big fan of Pyramid of the Pantheon. I've seen a few people play it. Maybe there's a time and a place for it, but that time and place is not pack one, pick one. I don't know what I want to take here. I like Cartouche a lot. It's a fine first pick. I've been really impressed by Synchronized Strike. Every time I cast it, I feel like I get at least a 1-for-1 and often a 2-for-1. I also fear it for my opponents. And I really like Bone Picker a lot, too. I just think it's a good card, just very solid. I'll go for the Cartouche this time. Start off with some removal. Holy crap. Wow, this pack's insane. Look at all these good cards. Crocodile, Stir the Sands, Splendid Agony, Trial. I could just take the Trial. This is interesting. Normally, I would take one of these two. I think that these are two premium cards in this color pair. And like Cartouche plus Crocodile is pretty absurd. It's just whack them and then kill one of their things and hit them again. Stir the Sands is just great. I think between the two, I would definitely take Crocodile of the Crossing just because I already have a green card and they're pretty close in power level. But I'm going to take Trial this time, I think. I just like having it, like, just this two, this combo right here is already just very strong. Watchful Naga, okay. I've liked it a little more than I did at first. I could take an Electrify, that wouldn't be bad either. Nah, I'll stick on color. Let's try to cut a bunch of green cards here and see what our other color is, maybe next pack, if the pack allows us to do so. Kind of weird we're on triple three drops, but I really like Trial Strength a lot, and anytime you can Cartouche with it, is any of the Trials, basically, it's just absurd. Like, I view that as, like, a potential sort of main game plan, even. Ooh, Foil Scattered Groves? That's cool. I'll just take this, though. Nothing else really great in the pack. I think this is better than Ornery Kudu. Alright, well, green three drops it is. Fear Us. So this is the order that I drafted. Now, there's some reasonable cards here, and Greater Sandworm has been downgraded from Greatest Sandworm to simply Greater Sandworm, but still, I think I'm going to take it here. I could take one of these blue cards. These are all fine. I just think that this is probably about on par anyway. All right, I'm going to take this Cartouche. If we end up playing green-white, this Cartouche is very, very good. Not only does it work with Trial of Strength, but also on a big creature, it just tends to be quite good. I think I'd like this better than an Essence Scatter or one of these medium-white cards. Yeah, Cartouche of Solidarity is quite good in these decks. Mighty Leap, I could take a Gift of Paradise or an Evolving Wilds. I like Evolving Wilds better than Painted Bluffs, but I don't think I want Gift. We're not really trying to do that. Mighty Leap is interesting. It works well with a lot of the cards we already have, but I'm just not convinced we're going to be white yet, so I'm going to take this Evolving Wilds. And this is the pack that we opened. Yeah, some good white cards here. I'll take this. Another Evolving Wilds? That's interesting. Yeah, I'm going to take it. And then there's a Mighty Leap. All right. Green three drops, dot deck continues. Well, we certainly don't have a strong pull to be in white, but we have a reasonable little start. Like if we open up a good white rare, like a Regal Caracal or something like that, you know, then it's just like, sure, slot it right in, off we go. But if we open up, you know, a great black rare, I have no problem going like this. That's totally fine by me. Also, all of the scenarios I'm describing have us opening a great rare, which is clearly going to happen. Yeah, but these combat tricks with two Watchful Nagas is pretty good, too. They always block this. They're very incentivized to block it because it's small, and because if they don't, then I get to draw another card at some point. And that makes combat tricks quite good. I like Manticore at pretty late. All right. So this is where I want to be going into the second pack. We have a reasonably strong deck. And we're looking for some upside here. Also, splash possibilities are very real. Ooh. Dusktodon. Well, I think that fit the description. We could take a Hooded Brawler instead, or an Edifice. But no, I'm going to take Dusktodon. That card's really good. And it fit exactly the description that we described. A good white rare that just sort of slots in. Artwork is savage on this card, too. All right.
I'm in. We're doing it.
Oh, man. I haven't played this card in a while. I don't know if I want it. We've got a Gift of Paradise and a Naga Vitalist. We also have Dusktodon. And it's funny because our... We do have kind of a value shell, actually. It's weird. I was thinking that our deck was a little bit more beat down than it is, because that's what green-white traditionally is, but it's really not. Like, removal spell, ramp creature, value creatures. I think we could actually make this thing work. We're going to need some help. Ooh, hello. Ooh. Well... Isn't this interesting? So Onkrop Champion, very solid card, would absolutely make the cut in a deck like this, was my first instinct, but I think I'm actually going to take Start to Finish here, because we have a super easy splash for black, and Start is already a fine card, and then if you get to Finish, it's just very good removal, and this actually has a decent chance of wheeling. If nobody else is in specifically green-white, nobody else wants this card, and since it's so early in the pack still, that gives us, I mean, this is only the second pick, that gives us the highest chance to wheel it, of course, because just by removal, there's going to be the second most possible cards left in the deck. So I'm going to take Start to Finish. Well, this pack fell a little flat for us, didn't it? I guess I'll just take Canyon Slough if we're going to splash. Jeez, I could just have Watchful Naga dot deck here. Probably just want the cartouche if we're splashing black anyway. And yeah, I'm going to take it. Okay, Colossipede I like. Anything else good here? Some stuff, but I want something big like this. Quarry Hauler or Binding Mummy? It's got to be Mummy here. We're a little light on twos. And Quarry Hauler's kind of mediocre anyway. Yeah, the cartouche is fine on the splash as well, because if you put it on something like this or like this, the game is just, like, done. I don't know if we'll end up playing the Gift of Paradise. It's possible. So this gets back all of our Watchful Nagas as well. It's kind of cool. Sure. Just gets that back too, doesn't it? Ooh, Hooded Brawler. Hoodie B, welcome to the team. Sure. Green three drops for days. Probably unlikely to play a Spidery Grasp in a deck like this. Nice. Got the Vitalist back. I like that. Yeah, this Canyon Slough is interesting because we can't surge it up with Evolving Wilds. It makes for a great second swamp because it works with Vitalist and it, of course, has Cycling. But if we only end up running one swamp in the deck, then I don't think we want a second mana source that doesn't make green. Supply Caravan, probably not going to make the cut, but it might. This card's perfectly playable, but I don't think we're going to be short playables in this deck, so I'd say it's unlikely that it makes the cut. Green, white, splash, black control, apparently. Definitely want a stinging shot. Yes, I love that. Having a couple of these in the board or even one of them in the main is very nice, because there's some decks that are pretty annoying with a bunch of flyers. And just having access to a removal spell of this caliber is really, really good against them. Still don't know if I want to play this. It's probably close. With two Vitalists, I might not need it. Glorious and Deemworthy. Seraph could make the cut. Colossus beat another Vitalist. All right, so this pack stinks for us. It's like Seraph or a Colossipede or another Vitalist. Those are our options. Probably just want another Vitalist. Seraph of the Suns is good against some decks and very bad against others. And unfortunately, there's quite a few color combos that it's not that great against, so I'm not really excited about it. Could take Watchers of the Dead, but I'd rather have this. All right. Vitalist. That probably kills this. Whoa. Heaven to Earth. Glyph Keeper, another Cartouche, a Decimator Beetle. Wow. Glyph Keeper, obviously the best card in the pack. But we are pretty far away from splashing it. I think our black splash is still better. So I'm going to take Decimator Beetle. Card is awesome. Oh, by the way, we never wheeled that other Onkrop Champion, which is noteworthy. I think we're just going to take this one, though. Could take Vizier of Remedies. It's very good against some decks, and it's fine against the rest. But Onkrop Champion's a beater, and we've got triple Naga Vitalist, so having good fours is a little higher on our list than it normally would be. So I'll take it. All right. Enough. Don't need any more of those. Might just want Forsake the Worldly over Takrop Elite here. Yeah, I'm gonna take it. Hooded Brawler or another Cartouche? I want another Cartouche. Man, every time we draw this Trial of Strength, we're gonna just go off. We've got multiple Cartouches, four of them here. Mountain for it, though. Quarry Hauler, okay. Man. It's just Naga Vitalist for days. Suppose we want one over an Initiate's Companion. Okay, that's a good pickup. Another nice five to go with our ramp plan. I like it. And I suppose I should just take the upside card here with the Seraph of the Suns. Having two just stone seven drops in your deck is probably not the best thing in this format, so I might start it in the sideboard, but against the decks it's good against, it's very good. And we certainly have the ability to power cards like that out. Sweet. I will play that. Okay. We've got some decisions to make on the deck for sure. think we can probably ditch the white cartouche now, given that we've got three of the others. So let's see what we're looking at here. So probably kill this thing and maybe like the white cartouche. The Mighty Leap's probably still fine. Like I said, it works well with these. It can actually just get in like a huge hit of damage to finish the game if it comes to that. We're pretty flexible on how we can spend our mana. The thing that we don't really have is the ability to draw a ton of cards. Like, we can get some of our cards back with Dusk to Dawn and stuff, but we're going to flood out a good amount of the time. So we really need these type of cards to be really great for us. And same thing with these cartouches, have to really kind of hold their own. Let's see what else we've got. Gift to Evolving Wilds. We could play the Seraph as another curve topper, but like I said, we've already got plenty of stuff to spend our mana on at the top end. I'm not super worried about it. And again, there's times when that card just doesn't even look very good. So do I want to run this Canyon Slough? I don't think so. Do I need two swamps? Maybe I do, actually. Yeah, I probably do. I've got three cards that I can't even cast unless I have a swamp, and I've got Start to Finish. And again, the Vitalists do work with Canyon Slough as well. All right, we'll play two swamps. Six, 11, 13, 16. So what we need to do here, though, is we do need one more green mana source. That's what I need to do. There we go. All right. Okay. Well, big ramp, big mana, and some payoffs at the top. So let's see what this thing can do.